Put God first in life. Bittersweet memories. Ecclesiastes 3:1-8 NLT. For everything there is a season, a time for every activity under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to harvest. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build up. A time to cry and a time to laugh. A time to grieve and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather stones. A time to embrace and a time to turn away. A time to search and a time to quit searching. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to mend. A time to be quiet and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace.
Hey, what's up, Kingdom Crew? So I know I promised you guys an update, okay? And I'm gonna try to make it a long story short because it's only a 3-minute video. But I made a video, I think yesterday morning, it was like 6 a.m. Or was that yesterday morning? Or the day before or something. Y'all can go back on my profile. And I was sitting on the curb on top of my stuff, and I just didn't know what to do. And God told me to make a video and ask for help, and so I did. And so I also want to thank everybody who reached out to me, everybody who sowed, everybody, because this is good ground, everybody who helped, everybody who encouraged, everybody who has been praying for me, everybody who has been rocking with me on this journey, because God told me to put this on screen. This is a very humbling place to be when you can actually share your life and the struggles that you're going through on camera for the world to see. So long story short, I was sitting at some place after I left the curb. I went to the library and I sat there in the bushes and the trees for like 9 hours. I didn't feel like going inside the library. I just needed a moment to myself. And at this point, I had a whole just moment with God. Like, he took me up into the spirit. And those who are actually chosen know what I'm talking about. Y'all know when God take you to the spirit and you're like just in a trance. You're just in a trance. Like, you can't move. Like, you're just fully, like, God is fully just taking you up. You're in a trance. And you feel God's love. You feel him surrounding you, holding you, speaking to you, everything. I was just in a trance yesterday. And he changed my whole mindset. He changed my whole attitude. He revived me. And so I'm like, you know what? I'm not sitting here all depressed in the bushes and the trees. I'm sitting here kicking it outside. And Jesus is right next to me. We're just kicking it, hanging out outside in his creation, right? So I had a whole new outlook on this whole homeless situation, right? Long story short, he sent his angels to come get me. Some people from a church came and saw me and was speaking to me, and I told them my situation and all that everything, and they're like, it is absolutely not okay for you to be on the streets and all that everything, and they got so many connections and stuff there. So anyways, long story short, these people, this church, actually the church is the one who paid for this, they put me in a hotel yesterday, today, tomorrow, and the next day, right? And then one of the ladies that is working with me, one of the people that God sent, said, I'm going to try to get you a place to stay, whether that's a friend, whether that's a shelter, whether that's whatever the case. And she was like, we're going to find out more on Monday. Mind you, today is Saturday. So she called me just a few minutes ago and was like, I got a place for you. So I'm going to have my own little dorm room. Okay, mom, I have my own little dorm room. Plenty opportunities to work, plenty of opportunities to resources, all that. I don't have to leave my stuff outside. I don't have to worry about all these crazy people out here or anything. But your girl is finally out of her Job season of losing everything. Now is the season of restoration, and I'm going to take y'all with me. Oh, glory to God. Oh, glory to God.
I'm going to tell you how to start a relationship with God. I've said this 1,000 times and I will continue to say this because it's so important. A relationship, any relationship, is built off of 3 things. Communication, spending time with the person, and getting to know the person. And that is the exact same thing with God. Communicate with him, pray to him, just talk to him. Sometimes we overcomplicate prayer when it's just talking to God. It's talking to him about your day. It's talking to him about what you're going through, your struggles, and repenting of your sins that you have done. Asking for forgiveness. Just talking to God. Next is getting to know God. How do you start a relationship, or how do you even trust someone that you don't know? So open the Bible. 2 Timothy 3:16 talks about how that's God's breathed out word. You want to know who God is? Look in the Bible, because that's where he's revealed his character in. And spend time with him. It is so important to have a daily routine so you have motivation to do this. Some days I wake up and I don't want to read my Bible. I'm lacking motivation. But the routine and spending time with God is what motivates me. So I hope this helped.
God will find you. Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment. Perfected Faces, done by Candy.
See, I didn't find God in the church. In fact, I didn't find God at all. He found me. He met me in a place where I was so broken, I couldn't get up. And when you're loved like that, it will shock you.
Whoever needs to hear this, listen now. God did not bring you this far to leave you. He did not bring you this far to... The scripture says that he that started a good work, he's faithful to see it through till the end. The work that the Lord has started in you is a good work, and he will surely see it through to the end. He says he makes all things work together for good for those that love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. You did not find God. Contrary to the way it is explained today that, oh, I found God. You did not find God. God was not lost. You was lost. God found you. And so if he finds you, he is big enough, strong enough, and able enough to secure you and to keep you. You've got to believe that. In the book of Matthew chapter 6, verse 44, it says, "No one can come to you unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day." Christ is saying that if the Father did not send you, if the Father did not send you to him, you will not be able to know him. So God found you. So you've got to believe that if he found you and he's brought you this far, then he's faithful enough, he's able enough, and he's more than willing to see you through to the very end, because he does a good work. He doesn't do unfinished business. No, the Lord finishes his work perfectly. The book of Ephesians 2 verses 10 says that we are God's masterpiece. We are God's masterpiece. Listen to these words. Created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared for us a long time ago. So before you were even born, there was a preparation for you. You've got to believe that, because it's true. Before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you. I'd set you apart. Right? So there's a preparation for you, there's a plan for you, there's a purpose for you, there's a path for you. And you are a masterpiece that is going through to perfection. You will be perfected. You're going through a process that is going to take you to perfection. The Lord did not bring you this far to leave.
God wants to be pursued. He's a relational God. He's a jealous God. He wants your heart. He wants your devotion. He wants your passion. In fact, he gives us an incredible promise in Jeremiah 29, verse 13. He says this, God says, "You will seek me." And what happens when you seek me? When you seek me, he says, you'll find me. It's a promise. If you pursue God, he will reveal himself to you. You will seek me and find me. When you seek me with all your heart, God says, I will be found by you, declares the Lord. When you draw near to him, when you pursue him, when you crave him, when you hunger for him, God loves to be pursued, and he loves to reveal himself to you.
To speak to people about a peg. So when you look at a peg, Sister Lerato, there's this silver spring in the center.
Yes.
A peg cannot function without the silver spring in the center. If I remove the silver spring in the center, it'll be just two pieces of planks that mean nothing. Same thing with your life. If I remove God at the center of your heart, you'll be a meaningless person. You wouldn't know your purpose. You wouldn't know your calling. You wouldn't know who you are. Number two, when you hang clothes on a line, why do you put a peg? You put a peg so that impacts a zinga or a zinga gold. Same thing with your life. Why do you receive God in your life? You receive God so that you don't fall into depression, anger, anxiety, bitterness, jealousy. That is why you need God in your life, so that you can be who you are and know your identity and purpose. Number three, if I remove the clothes from the pegs, so that is why it's very important to stick on. unto the Lord. Number four, EPEX does not discriminate, Sisley Rudd. Lezi impahla igqokile, doesn't matter whether you are rich, whether you are poor, whether you are filthy, whether you are dirty. EPEX's job is to hold impahla. It does not matter who you are, EPEX is going to hold you. Isn't this is the same thing that God says, come as you are. It doesn't matter how broken, it doesn't matter what happened in your life. God is saying that just come as you are. Right now, during this lockdown, there's somebody that's broken. It's saying that I have no future. There's no hope, Bongani. But I want to tell you, God is saying, come as you are. And the word fear, Sisley Rado, the word fear, this word, fear, it has two meanings for me, Sisley Rado. It says first meanings from the enemy. And people will say, forget everything and run away from the promises that God has for you. It's saying forget. But I want you to turn it around today. I don't care what situation you're facing today. Turn it around. Face everything and rise. I don't care what situation you've been through. A lot of people, they might have thrown stones. Like dogs do not bark at a car that stands still. But dogs bark at a car that's moving. So what I'm telling you, run. Hustle. It's difficult. Today I'm an author, Sisley Rado. My friends, when I shut my
in the mirror lately, wish you could trade eyes with me. There's complexities in complexion, but your skin is glow like diamonds. Dig me like the earth, you be giving birth to everything alive, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls to every single curve, your body natural. Same skin that was broken, be the same skin taking over. Most things are to focus you, but when you're in the room, they notice you. Cause you're beautiful. Yeah, you're beautiful. Them and them gon' fall in love with you and all of your glory. Your skin is not only dark, it shines and it tells your story. Keep dancing, they can't control you. They watching, they all adore.